Hi, I'm Ajay Eshkol. I'm one of the interventional cardiologists here at Centerpoint Medical Center, and I'm here today with Dr. Scott Kerber, who's an electrophysiologist. We have a new technology that we're bringing to Centerpoint that allows some patients with atrial fibrillation to come off of their blood thinners, and we'd like to tell you a little bit more about it. So I thought we could start out by introducing you to the atrial fibrillation. So Dr. Kerber, can you tell us a little bit more about atrial fibrillation and what's important to patients regarding?
Sure. So as Dr. Eshkol said, my name is Dr. Kerber. I'm one of the heart rhythm doctors, kind of heart rhythm specialist. So heart rhythm issues such as atrial fibrillation is our specialty. So first off, atrial fibrillation is the most common arrhythmia in the world. And it's mainly a disorder of the top two chambers of the heart. So if you picture the heart, you have two top chambers and two bottom chambers. So when the normal heart is beating, the normal pacemaker for the heart starts in the top right chamber, and that squeezes, and that fires automatically, and it sends that signal to both top chambers to make the top chambers squeeze rhythmically. Okay, and then from there, that signal goes from the top chambers down to the bottom chambers via another connection called the AV node. So a normal heartbeat starts as the top chamber squeezing and then the bottom chamber, nice and rhythmic. The problem with atrial fibrillation is that you have an extra beat that usually comes in from one of the top left chambers. And so it kind of short circuits the whole top chamber. So instead of the top chamber squeezing nice and slow and rhythmically, an extra beat comes in and makes them quiver. So then instead of having that nice controlled top chamber, the atrial beating, it just quivers. And then the bottom chamber beats erratic. And so there's a couple of problems with atrial fibrillation, and the most feared one is a stroke, because the blood is not squeezing out of the top chamber, it's quivering, and so blood is pooling in the top chamber. And if blood pools in there long enough, it can form a blood clot and therefore a stroke. And so that's why a lot of our patients that have atrial fibrillation are all on blood thinners, such as Xarelto, Pradaxa, Eliquis, Coumadin. The point of that is to quote unquote thin the blood in order to prevent a blood clot from forming in that top chamber.
And so the blood thinners are very good, and we understand from thousands of patients that they're generally safe and really the best way to prevent stroke if a patient can tolerate them. But as you can imagine, sometimes patients can't take blood thinners.
Yeah.
And in those patients, there's a really good suitable alternative that's been available since about 2015, but it's gradually been implanted in thousands of patients. It's called a left atrial appendage closure procedure. And this procedure addresses a small pouch in the heart called a left atrial appendage. This little pouch is where most of the large strokes come from. And instead of using a blood thinner to prevent clots from forming in that pouch, we can put a device into that pouch and seal it off so that clots don't form and we can prevent stroke. And this procedure is something that is done in the hospital, and it takes about 1 hour. We bring a catheter, a hollow tube from the leg vein, bring it up to the heart and go into this little pouch and then deploy the device. It takes about 1 hour and the patients recover over a one night stay in the hospital and they are released home the next day. Can you tell us a bit about the procedural, any risks or benefits from this procedure compared to blood thinners?
Yeah, so like Dr. Eshkol was just saying, it's been studied in thousands of patients, and the risk and efficacy of the device has been shown to be non-inferior to blood thinners, particularly in those patients that can't tolerate blood thinners. And so some patients that might be in that category would be patients that have any bleeding issues, such as GI tract bleeding, so blood in your stools, any patients that have balance issues, that have frequent falls, or any people that have some sort of anemia or problem that they have to get blood transfusion. So there's more that can be included in that category, but those are kind of the highlights of those patients.
And in terms of the comparison to blood thinners, you'll notice that the stroke risk is about the same in both groups, if people who get blood thinners versus the procedure. But the procedure does have some small risks that we would review with you before going forward.
Yeah. So, I think the next step for any patients that may be interested in this, if you are a patient that has atrial fibrillation and that are on blood thinners, and you have some concerns about these blood thinners, there's a number that you can call at the bottom of the screen. And we can get in touch with you from there and then maybe schedule an appointment to discuss further options going forward with anticoagulation versus if you may be a candidate for this procedure.